Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
So about a month ago, I put together a video showing how you can use a braking resistor as a way to slow down a DC motor and effectively add an electric brake to whatever you're driving with that motor. So in my case, I did all this work for my lathe. I wanted to have the lathe spindle stop as quickly as possible when I flipped the switch to braking mode. If you haven't seen that video, make sure you go back and take a peek. I was posting that information and that video on the Mill Lathe Combo Facebook page, and one of the very intelligent gentlemen there said, well, that's great, and it's nice for emergency situations, but it would be a whole lot more user-friendly if you could make it so that when the power is turned off, the brake automatically engages. And I thought, you know what? That makes a lot of sense. So this right here is a relay. It is a double pole, double throw relay. You have a normally open and a normally closed setting. So what that means is when it's normally closed, the switch is in the on position. Then you have the normally open setting where it's in the off position. And when you energize the coil on this, it switches the two. So the one that was on now becomes off, and the one that was off now becomes on. And this is the heart of the project. So by connecting the motor to these two terminals right here and connecting my resistor to these two right here, when it's in the resting position, the motor is connected to the resistor, and that is going to create the braking action. When you energize the coil, it connects the motor here to the power inputs here and here, and that sends power to the motor. So I thought, piece of cake, simple. We attach this relay and bam, we have an automatic brake. But that's only if we're using the power switch. What about if we're using the forward and reverse switch? We got to find a way to connect both of those switches to this relay and get it to work as a brake. That's where this comes in. This is the original switch that came on my mill lathe combo machine. Now, this switch is a whole lot more complicated, and I'm not sure if all rotary switches are wired the same. So if you don't know the specific configuration of your rotary switch, you need to do what I did, and that's to take a multimeter, put it in the continuity setting, and test all these terminals and figure out where the power is flowing. Ultimately, I discovered that this terminal and this terminal were the common terminals, the ones getting switched to something. So I set those up with male ends to go to my motor. Being that it's DC, we have polarity. So I have the negative on this side and I have the positive on this side. But what's really cool about this switch is if you look right there, there's a jumper connecting this terminal to this terminal and this terminal to this terminal. There's a jumper right there too. And that does the same thing as the crisscross wires that you normally see in a double pole, double throw direction switch. So by using this half of the switch to control direction, I can go forward and reverse. Again, this switch is center off. And then these last four, the blue ones are gonna go to my AC hot, and my white ones are going to go to my AC neutral, so that we're killing the power from here to here and from here to here when it's in the neutral position. But when it's in the forward position or the reverse position, these wires are connected and supplying power to the relay. Once I had this all wired up and I thought everything was in the correct spot, I tested it again, especially since we're dealing with using this as a direction reversing. So we're reversing the positive and the negative. If you don't have it set up correctly, you could short something out and create all kinds of problems. So this is a triple pole double throw switch. Now, this is way too small for this application, but the good news is this is configured the exact same way that a switch that is large enough for this application would be. The center terminals are the ones being switched, and they're either being switched to this side or this side up the row. So we wire this just the way we would with a double pole double throw switch, using these six terminals to control the forward and reverse direction, and using these three terminals to turn off and on the AC that goes to the coil. So by using this switch, I will be able to control power to this coil, and when this is in the off position, there will be no power to this coil, so the brake will be engaged. When the master power is cut, there will be no power to this coil, and the brake will be engaged. When the master power is on, and this is either in the forward or reverse position, the coil in this relay will be engaged, the brake will effectively be disengaged, and power will be flowing to the motor. Simple setup, easy to do, all because of this relay. Now, here's the important thing about relays. These treadmill motors are high voltage, high amperage. So your basic treadmill motor is right around 90 volts, and your basic amperage draw on those is 15 to 20. If you don't understand how relays work and how voltage and amperage affect the functionality of a relay, you're going to undersize your relay. This relay is designed to work with both AC and DC. This is 80 amps at 110 volts AC. And you would think, well, that's plenty. It's 80 amps. That's going to be enough. But on the DC side, it's 80 amps at only 24 volts. The good news is voltage and amperage are related. Let's say you're looking at a switch and it's rated at 10 amps at 220 volts. It'll likely be rated at 20 amps at 110 volts. So we can mathematically figure out where the amperage rating is on this. So if we take this up to 90 volts, we're dropping the amperage rating down to about 24, which is still plenty of amps for this project. But your basic, cheap, low amp relay will not work. It needs to be a heavy duty one just like this. I know this looks like a jumbled rat's nest of wires, but it's really not as bad as it appears. I'm going to put a wiring diagram on here that shows how this works. It's really pretty simple. But for the bench test demonstration, what I want to show you is that there are two ways to have the relay engage. So we're going to take and turn the power on. Nothing happens because this is in the neutral position. If we go reverse, you heard it click and the switch inside moved. Then we take and go back to off, it shuts it off. We go forward, same thing. Now in that forward position, if we kill the master power switch, shuts the relay off. So we are at the braking motion. Now what's really cool about this is I'm going to be able to add this emergency stop switch. It will be tied to the master AC power coming in. So if there's a problem, I can just hit the switch and kill the system. So here's the bench test with the motor. Comes on, we cut main power, brake engages. We turn it to the off position on the direction control, brake engages. We turn it to reverse, turn it off, brake engages. So this is a fantastic setup. Because of this relay, everything is automatic. Anytime I turn the direction, it's going to engage the brake. Anytime I cut the master power, it's going to engage the brake. And if I hit the emergency stop switch, it's going to engage the brake. Now, all this will be cleaned up significantly when I put it in the lathe, but for a bench test, this is all I needed.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.